What do you think you're doing?
Relax, I didn't drive and I caught the bus. Anyway, I thought you were supposed to be on leave.
Well, I had some things to sort out. And don't change the subject. What do you think you're doing with TK's laptop?
Oh, he said I could take it.
Oh, right. TK said, here's my laptop. Don't worry about all the confidential patient notes on it. You just got
it. Why don't you just ask him yourself?
Ask me what?
Do you think I'm stealing your laptop?
Oh, I said he could take it for the afternoon.
Oh, don't cover for him, TK. I'm not stupid.
TK's having trouble with the operating system, and I said I'd get rid of the extensions that were slowing it down. I'm fixing it, okay?
I told him it broke down all the time. You really wanted to make up for taking your car?
I'm sorry, I didn't know. I just saw you and I just thought...
The worst? Yeah, I figured that one out.
Hello, Mr. Watts. I'm Chris Warner. We'll sort you with some pain relief. I'm just going to listen to your chest, okay? The subclavian artery has been punctured. Movement to the left lateral position. I'll dislodge the wire from there. Any reason why the HOD wasn't called in for this?
She's in theatre. We get called.
So where's her cover? Mr. Watts, I'm just getting rid of the guide wire. You'll feel much better in a minute. That's got it. Janice, could you apply a pressure dressing? We'll also need a chest CT to assess the extent of the damage.
Sure. I'm so sorry.
Happens to everyone. Mikhail was just in thinking delegating a patient like this.
I don't think she realised Janice was so out of her depth.
Janice is a junior registrar. She should never have been put in this position.
I can't believe these guys. What part of leave me alone don't they understand?
Yeah, well, 4 points for tenacity, I suppose. May I?
Yeah, be my guest.
Gentlemen, can I help you?
Is Claire around?
No, I'm afraid so. She's not.
Claire, we'd like to talk.
I'm sorry, I'll say it again. Claire's not home. Not to you.
And you are?
Brother Mitchell, pleased to meet you.
Juliet, okay. We're all friends.
Then you respect that Claire has the right to pursue other religious options. And in the meantime, she'd appreciate it if you didn't call again.
Give this to her, eh?
From what I understand, New Zealand has a very efficient postal service. Support your local infrastructure, eh, lads.
You were amazing.
No, nothing. Do you want coffee?
Sure.
Should be ready in a couple of days.
Well, that's great. Thanks. Hey, okay.
Hey, mate. So, you're taking on the entire hospital IT contract now, huh? You're rolling in the money.
No, I just thought, you know, tap out and stuff.
Dude, you got a thing or two to learn about business. At least let me shut your feet to say thanks, huh?
Sucking up to the girlfriend's kid.
Just trying to do you a favour here, man. Okay, you got me. Of course I want you and me to get along.
What, even after the Grand Theft Auto?
Hey, I borrowed the occasional car when I was your age.
Serious?
Yeah. Then Shanti's keys, took her up to the beach. Don't tell your mum, okay? Anyway, I'm really glad you're around. It's important to your mum. And me. You're not going to spend your whole holidays fixing these.
No. I've got other stuff I need to take care of.
Okay, how about Wistful?
Oh, please. After performing an op I've been waiting for all my life, wistful isn't the word I'd choose.
I need to have a word. Could you excuse us, please?
Yeah, well, we're done. Thank you, Dr. Jones.
You're welcome, and thank you.
Please explain to me why you left Janice alone to perform a subclavian central line insertion.
It's a standard procedure. She's more than up to it. Not still sore about the HOD meeting, are you?
She cannulated the subclavian artery instead of the vein. She nearly lost the patient. Where the hell were you?
What?
Luckily, Maya had the presence of mind to call me.
They rang while I was operating. They never said it was so serious. That's why I left Janice to it.
You told me this morning you were adequately covered. Janice should have been supervised. Instead, you were off feathering your own nest. You cannot afford to be dropping the ball like this. It is an extremely serious lapse of judgment.
So, what now?
Best case scenario, the patient doesn't lay a formal complaint. Don't hold your breath.
I totally believe in the Christian principles, being kind and helping each other out and stuff, but I just can't stretch to taking the Bible literally.
Well, I don't know. Men being swallowed by whales, oceans parting, and women turning to salt. All sounds perfectly feasible to me.
Ha ha, you're such a tough guy. Hi. What are you two fighting about?
I was just boring poor Kieran with God stuff, and he got a bit cheeky.
It wasn't boring. Hey, Liv, look, about the way I spoke to you last night, it wasn't on. I'm sorry. I guess working for a living again's making me cranky.
I thought you'd be an old hand at bartending by now.
Well, yes, I have poured many a drink and listened to many a tale in many a seedy bar. Now that is boring.
Yeah, well, you should try photocopying and answering phones for a living.
I bet you have way better work stories than us.
Well, people getting drunk and throwing up, it's not exactly riveting.
Come on, stories. You must have heaps of goodies.
God, let's see. No, mine's gone completely blank.
You're a spoil sport.
Oh, look at the time. Jay's gonna have my ass on the plate. I'll see you later.
Bye.
What? Don't be mad at me.
Oh, well, I'm not.
I wasn't making a play for him. It's just friends.
Same again?
Thank you. So, how's your new barman coming along?
Kieran? Yeah, he's really good. He hasn't had any more of those funny turns. He certainly keeps customers entertained.
I guess you guys do need a few stories up your sleeve.
Yeah. Oh, actually, I heard a great one the other day. You know Kelly from the kitchen? Well, he used to work in this pub, and they had this trapdoor behind the bar. So it's happy hour on Valentine's Day, and the barmaid is so busy, she forgets that this trapdoor is open. The landlady walks by, and she falls straight down into the cellar. And these two drunk guys sitting at the bar, they see her fall, and they tell the barmaid. But she thinks it's a wind-up, so the trapdoor gets closed.
What happened?
Well, she's stuck down there for 4 hours with a broken ankle. So she polishes off the best of two bottles of gin, and when she's lifted out, all hell breaks loose. Turns out that the barmaid is having an affair with the landlord, so the landlady is convinced that she did it on purpose.
Oh, Osh would have a field day.
There you go.
Thank you.
What's tickled your fancy?
Oh, Kelly's trapdoor story. Have you heard it?
No.
I can't apologise enough, Mrs. Watts. Thank you for coming in.
He'll be all right, won't he?
Yes, but as I mentioned, his recovery time will be significantly lengthened.
Not bloody good enough.
Mr. Watts' family, I take it.
And?
They've decided to lay a formal complaint.
Great. Just what you need.
You'll need to write a full report for the board, outline what happened.
Hopefully they'll see it for what it was. An inexperienced registrar overstating her experience and a very forgivable breakdown of communication.
We may get off that lightly, but I doubt it. Not if the family go public on us.
Fingers crossed they don't. Someone as green as Janice doesn't deserve crucifixion by media.
No, she doesn't. Not when the supervising surgeon and more experienced staff member should take responsibility.
Me? It was hardly my fault.
This isn't about blame. It's about you stepping up.
And ruining my career. Forget it. She told me she was confident to act alone.
Your decision.
Okay, so what'll it be? The Aussie thong or the chick flick?
Neither really look that promising.
Fine, I'll just talk to myself then, shall I? You guys are truly pathetic.
Sorry? What?
You need to decide which one of you is going there and get on with it. It's painful to watch.
Trust me.
Well, for your information, neither Claire nor I are going there.
Yeah? Oh, please. You're like Bridget Jones and her tragic younger sister. Only way worse and way more desperate.
All right for drinks here, ladies. Can I interest anybody in a cocktail?
Warm. Getting warmer.
Oh, we're fine.
Oh, the good news is I remembered.
Remembered what?
My favourite barroom story.
Oh, cool.
Yeah, it's when I was working in this pub in Soho, and there was a trapdoor behind the bar, and it was Valentine's night, absolutely madly busy, so somebody forgets to shut the trapdoor. Now, the landlady, she falls down. The only people who see her are these two drunken regulars at the end of the bar who tell the barmaid, but she assumes it's a wind-up. So she shuts the trapdoor, and that's it. Good night, nurse.
Oh,
Yeah, and so?
So, the landlady is stuck down there for 4 hours. A broken ankle, seriously unhappy. She gets so sick of screaming, she drinks 2 bottles of gin. And by the time they let her out, all hell breaks loose. Turns out the landlord is having an affair with the barmaid, and the landlady is convinced she shut her down there on purpose.
Oh, my gosh!
Yeah, thank you very much.
I can see what the fuss is about. Hey, hands off, you're married.
I can still look.
Come on then. Sushi first and then chick flick.
I'll meet you there. I've got a few things I need to do.
Suit yourself.
How long have they been married again?
Mum and Dad?
40 years.
That's a pretty solid effort, really. It's a pity I didn't inherit the gene.
What?
What's so funny?
I wonder if they still...
Oh, the mind pictures are not pretty. How am I supposed to get through the anniversary party now?
Speaking of which, do you need to buy them a present?
Oh, yeah. I got my cash back. Mm. Time you coughed up for the computer, bro.
Hey, what happened to payback for pinching the car, bro?
Oh, come on. You're a big flash doctor. It's not like you can't afford it.
Okay. 40 bucks to you?
Sweet. Well, that's me.
What, you off to bed already? It's a bit early, isn't it?
Yeah, I got some mangas to read in the seatbelt.
Comics. This guy knows how to have a good time.
Well, see you, Squirt. And I'm sorry about today.
You need to chill out.
Exactly what I've been telling you.
Chilling out as we speak. Hey, Dan, there's some dessert in the fridge. Help yourself.
Thanks.
That's the only comment we can give you at the moment. No, I'm not stonewalling. I'm just saying we can't give you any more until we've followed our formal internal process. Yes, I'm sure. All right. Goodbye. The Northerner. The family made contact a couple of hours ago.
What did you tell them?
As little as possible.
Which means they'll take whatever crumbs the family gives them and turn it into a meal?
Yeah, usually the way it works. Anything else?
I thought about what you said. You're right, I should front up. Janice doesn't deserve to be hung out to dry. Well?
What do you want, a round of applause? Taking responsibility is the fundamental requirement of anyone in an HOD position. It's the very least I expect of you.